Hey sisters, I am back from a much needed break and I get to share part of my story with Olay, and the timing couldn't be more perfect. 2018, I learned some valuable lessons and I'm going to share with you how I overcame some issues. This was actually terrifying to me. We can be our own worst enemies. And I'm not saying that we don't have to deal with outside forces that pose challenges in our lives, but sometimes we don't realize that the battle is within. Like, it's truly within. And that was where I had to look. And I really overcame some serious things that I didn't even know I was suffering from. There was a serious wake-up call. Like, my intuition had been telling me something was wrong. And ladies, we all know about the intuition. It's so real. Trust it. That saved my son's life. I had to trust it this time too, because my mental and physical health were on a decline and I literally felt like I was dying on the inside. Like, I didn't recognize the woman in the mirror. I didn't know who she was. I literally looked in the mirror and I was like, who's that? Something in me was dying and I was afraid to die, but I was also afraid of living.
Okay, what do you do with that?
So I did what I had to do, which was I stopped and I focused on what matters the most. And so often we don't do that. And that was me. So during this time, I was suffering from postpartum depression. I was very familiar with depression, but what I did not know and I was unaware of was that I was suffering from complex PTSD from life experiences and things that had happened. And we really don't put enough emphasis on how PTSD affects a lot of us. Like, you can have PTSD from a car accident. And I had two car accidents. Two during my pregnancy. Two! One in my first trimester and the other one was in my third trimester. And giving birth to Phoenix was very traumatic. There was that trauma right there. I didn't know that it was PTSD I was suffering from on top of depression, which that's like one of the symptoms. And I'm so glad that I took this time because I was finally able to address that, because I could not talk about Phoenix's birth without crying. That was one of the signs I learned in therapy, that that was trauma. Every time I tried to talk about it in detail, I cried. I think I talked about it in at least two videos. I think I cried in both of those videos. I'm sure I did. I'm such a big baby, but I can talk about it now without crying. Like, I still feel stuff, but it's not, the level is, it's down there, okay? But he almost died, and that was traumatic. He ended up losing a lot of his blood, like a lot. He ended up needing 3 blood transfusions, and I was told that if I would have waited hours, that I would have lost him. And it was literally my intuition that was telling me something was wrong. What scared me is that if I hadn't have gone, and if I didn't trust my intuition, I would have lost my son. That really, that hit me hard. And I wasn't dealing with it. And I was told, and I don't think any of these comments were intentionally meant to harm, but they're like, you should be happy. You know, you did so good. You know, some moms don't get to leave the hospital with their babies. And he survived. You came in right on time. But it was still traumatic for me. And when our experiences are invalidated and you don't want to have to deal with the judgment and shame that comes with, you know, not being this happy, energetic mother that can do it all, and you know, you don't want to be deemed unfit because you don't fit the picture perfect image of a mom that society has set up, and that can lead to denial. You'll think like, oh well, it's really not that bad, I'll get it together, or just put on this mask. And you end up suffering in silence, suffering alone, because of unrealistic expectations that society has put on women in general. We're supposed to do it all and be happy about it. What? And if you're not careful, because of our upbringing and what we've been taught and conditioned, you will also be biased towards yourself and other women. And that's what I had to realize was happening as well. I had to overcome that because I was really, really limiting myself. So all of these pressures, like smart and educated, this certain body type, is so unrealistic for a lot of women, especially postpartum. You're supposed to want to get married, be wife material. You know, you work and you hold down a house too, and all of these things. That's just this much of it. And we take on all of this and so much more, and we do it with a smile. Like, we do so much and we don't give ourselves enough credit. And let's not forget the prejudice and bias we have against the working moms. Oh, well, she's more into her career, not her home life. Single moms, why doesn't she have a man? Blah, 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 blah. Stay at home mom, she should have all of this done, but all she has to do is, you know, stay at home, take care of the kids. That is a full-time job. Work from home moms, like, oh, she hasn't made, she should be able to do this and do that because she's already at home. Let's not forget the women that choose to not have children. They don't want to. The pressure of having it, you get that question, when you're gonna have kids, and whenever you say I don't want any, it's like shame. Or they have been trying and they can't conceive, they have not been successful. That is very harmful as well. There's just so much coming from different angles, and that's just, again, it's just like this much of it. And look at us as women. We take on all of this. We take on all of it, and we do it with a smile. We're standing tall, and we have these capes flying in the wind, but I'm getting to it now. A lot of us are wearing a mask, and I was wearing one, okay? I've never been the type of person to act like I had it all together. Like, I'll tell you in a minute, like, girl, I need to get it together. But I really didn't know how much I didn't have it together. Like, I was in some type of denial, and I didn't know how much I didn't love myself and how unconfident I was, because it's like, hey, you didn't put yourself out here on social media. Like, give yourself some credit. My self-love was like way down here, okay? Sometimes deep down, like what I'm about to tell you about what's in your subconscious and what you're unconsciously thinking, like you don't know you're really thinking it. Sometimes we really don't love ourselves as much as we think we do. And when I decided to put myself first for like the first time ever, I realized that I was valuing other people's opinions and what they thought just way too much, like looking and seeking for validation or comparing myself. And that can rob you of your peace of mind. That's a toxic combination, and it can easily lead to being in a depressed mood, just going down Instagram comparing yourself to everybody. It's like, oh my gosh, they're doing this, I should be doing that, and blah 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 blah. And I was beating myself up and putting myself down, like, oh, I can't do that because of XYZ. And like, these thoughts kept me from trying. I literally needed to free me of myself. So I had to think, all these self-limiting things I'm telling myself, would I say this to someone else? Like, would I tell Tony or Carmen this? Would I say this to my sisters or my mom or any other friends or women or men, anyone? Would I say this? And no, I wouldn't. So why am I being so hard on myself? Why are you beating yourself up? So I learned how powerful the subconscious mind is through therapy. But once I made a lot of the unconscious conscious, I was able to identify a lot of my issues, and we all have them, and a lot of my flaws and a lot of the wounds that still needed to be healed and I hadn't addressed. And if you're really honest with yourself when you do this, if you're truly honest, that is scary. It can be so terrifying that some people will decide to just wear a mask and be in denial their entire lives. They'll wear it their entire lives. They will not accept any responsibility or any blame, or they'll always blame their shortcomings and things that go wrong on someone else, and they will refuse to look within and face those issues. Like, there are some people that refuse to address themselves. I want to say this was the bravest and most responsible thing that I have ever done. Of course, I cried a lot, but I also healed during the process. I dug deep and found the ugliest parts, but they led to me finding the most beautiful parts. And the things that I thought I hated about myself, I ended up finding self-love. And this has been a beautiful journey and process, and I just want to let you know that there is a light at the end of the tunnel. Like, listen to me. just know that if you're stuck, if you feel like you're at a point in your life and you're suffering from some things, depression, addiction, abuse, there are just things going wrong and you feel like you have nowhere to turn and you just like, why can't I get it together? Like, if you're just in that spot, you know, the spot I'm talking about, have some mercy on yourself. You deserve, love yourself the way you should love yourself. And you may not know you're not doing it right now, but you have to surrender to yourself. And my advice is the first place to look is within, because that's where you're going to find your truth. That's where the healing will begin. This is liberating. So yes, I went through therapy and I did a lot of research, tons of reading during this time. And I also, I started meditating and just loving myself. And I hope this video helps and it reaches someone. And again, like, you have to be brave. You have to be fearless when you do this because it is hard. You're just like, oh, and you're saying look within. But when you're truly honest with yourself, that can be hard. You know how they say the truth hurts? But that's what I had to do. And I'm so glad to be back. And I really hope this video touched and helped someone. And if you made it to this point, thank you so much for watching. And yeah, until next time, peace out, sisters.